would you listen to that calming harp music? Doesn't that just make you feel so magical and calm and mystical and like there's nothing going on in the world? Because that's what it's supposed to do. In fact, this whole video is supposed to make you feel calm and mystical and like nothing is wrong in the world. So hopefully it does that. Today we're going to be trying something a little new on this channel. I'm very excited about it. I was excited while I was recording the video for this. We're going to be drawing together, and you will see my process, kind of, or lack thereof, and I'm pretty sure that you can see how disorganized I am just by this pencil case already. I don't even know really what's in there. Feels like an endless bag to me, and I think I found a Q-tip in there once. Anywho, I can already feel that we're going to get off track pretty often here. There will not be speaking the whole time. I'll let you listen to the lovely little harp tune that plays throughout this video. But essentially, I'm going to be working on one of my final thesis pieces. And it's going to be a mixture of media, mostly watercolor and colored pencil, which is sort of how I've done everything. And as you can see by this nearly invisible sketch, I do a little bit of preliminary sketching at the beginning, just enough to give me a guide as to the direction I'm heading in. And yes, I did start moving very fast just then. That will be happening throughout the video. I'll do some time-lapse moments because this drawing did take a few hours, and you know, clearly I wasn't going to record the whole few hours and make you sit through it, so. Anyways, back to thesis pieces. It's one of my final pages that is just supposed to be like a happy, celebratory, decorative page that talks about how mushrooms can save the world, because my whole thesis is like an educational guide to mushrooms, and it's like an illustrated sort of beginner's book, I suppose? If you've seen stuff on my Instagram, you kind of know what's going on. You can see here that I'm starting with this like watercolor wash, which sometimes sets the tone for the rest of the piece. I gotta be honest, that was way muddier than I wanted it to be. In fact, when I started laying it down and it was gray, I was like, oh shit. Did not expect it to be that, but you know what? Like Tim Gunn says, we're gonna make it work, and I did in the end. Spoiler alert, it turns out all right. So now I go in and define some of the shapes that I feel most confident about, and that's like five of them, in all honesty. This whole composition, before I began, I was so unsure on. And up until about halfway through the piece, I was sweating. I was actually sweating profusely. And that happens most of the time when I'm working. And you can even see here that I suddenly have switched to a colored pencil, probably due to my panic. Like, oh god, I can't see this coming together, so I've got to add some structure back into it. Because after I do that first wash, often the pencil sketch that I did will nearly disappear. And I always know that that's going to happen. It's just a very loose guide for the composition, not so much a strict guide for every element of the piece. As for my materials, I will definitely have to kind of look up what this watercolor palette is, because I'm not sure. It was actually a gift to me when I was visiting Japan by one of my mom's friends, who is also an artist. She like completely surprised me and pulled this honker out from a gift bag and was like, oh yeah, use this, I got you this. And it's really, really nice. Like, it's lasted me now 4 years, and the color is really pigmented. I love the whole palette. I think they've got some really nice earthy tones and some really rich, bold colors in there. Again, if I can find the name of it, I will link it in the description. colored pencils, of course, I think you saw for a second, were just Prismacolors, nothing too special. I mean, they do the trick for me. Are they the best colored pencils in the world? I don't know. You can see at this point, I've now put in my, as I was talking about, confident shapes. I've passed the point where I'm like, okay, I know that these shapes are supposed to be here. And at this point, now it's a free-for-all, so I'm kind of just like going in and adding details to make it pop and adding some more guidelines for myself with the colored pencil. After a while, the image starts to sort of reveal itself to me. I think that's, not to compare myself to Michelangelo, but I'm pretty sure that's the whole thing that he saw in the marble, was like, the figure was trying to come out of the marble, and it was revealing itself to him, and he just had to, like, carve it out and free him, I guess. You see that really orange, incredibly orange, like, icky looking leaf that I just made? Yeah, not fun. but you'll see right here, I kind of go in and fill it in the watercolor, and this, especially on this paper, which, oh gosh, I wish I knew what paper this was. I bought one sheet of it, and it's quite soft, almost like a fabric-y texture of watercolor paper. But basically it absorbs really well and blooms quite a bit, which is when you drop another color of watercolor into another color. That made a lot of sense. And it does that sort of bloom pattern outwards, which I really love, and which is the whole reason why I use traditional media, especially watercolors, because I love those little errors that aren't really errors. Here's a fun fact about the flower that I'm painting. They're in Animal Crossing, and in Animal Crossing, they're called Jacob's Ladder. And I know that you get them when you have, like, a super beautiful town, in New Leaf, at least. So I was like, wow, I love those Jacob's Ladders. I should look them up and see what the actual flower looks like. When you look them up, I don't think that they're actually called Jacob's Ladders, because it's just some, like, horror movie. I can't find that flower, and it's just so lovely and dainty, and I would really, if a botanist is watching this, please tell me what those flowers are called, because I think they're just lovely. They're those little, like, bell-shaped white flowers that point downward and kind of droop. Now this picture is starting to look like a picture to me, and this is the point where I think I stopped sweating. See, it took almost, what, like halfway? Yeah, halfway to stop sweating. So if anybody thinks I'm super confident when I'm drawing, oh, absolutely not. And if anybody's watching me, I'm like, I'm definitely sweating, like, buckets, like, three times the amount I would be sweating on my own, which is a lot in general. You know, you watched this video and you thought you were going to get a really educational, calming experience, and now I'm just talking about my bodily fluids. So I just hope that you were ready for that. I guess I'll talk a little bit about thesis, I guess, if anybody wants to know about that, since we're here chatting together in my bed. Not together. I mean, if you want. Thesis at Ringling College, and I think quite a few art schools, is where you basically pick a topic or subject matter, and you do a series of pieces based off of that thing, or idea, or theme, whatever. And, you know, for mine, I chose mushrooms. And usually people can kind of do whatever they want. They could do, like, a comic book, they could do a series of posters, they could do an installation. Just the final product has to be in book form. So no matter what you did, it has to be formatted as a book to present. Now, mine is a book. Like, I don't even know why I really decided to do this, because am I trying to pursue book art? Not necessarily. But for some reason, it made the most sense for me to make this basically field guide to mushrooms for beginners. And a lot of the process, a lot of the time-consuming process was research and making sure my facts were correct. Because you can't just go shouting about mushrooms willy-nilly, because someone might get hurt. And certainly it's nothing to be taken lightly. I definitely had to have multiple sources, and I absolutely gave a disclaimer at the beginning about don't use this as a guide. Oh wait, let me interrupt myself. This is gouache. Do you guys know what gouache is? Maybe you do. It's kind of like a cross between acrylic and watercolor. You can add water to it and water it down a little bit, but it's thicker than a watercolor. So I like to use white to go over top of my watercolor, and you'll see in just a moment. Anywho, I was talking about thesis. Guys, I don't remember what I was saying. I was saying something about... Oh, yes, you can't go eating a mushroom in the wild. So I put a disclaimer about, you know, don't use this as your only source of information and go out and pick some mushrooms, because I am a citizen scientist, which I learned is the proper term for someone like me that just thinks these things are neat and does my own research about them, but isn't pursuing it as like an education or a degree. Now this is my favorite part of drawing those fly agaric mushrooms, those, like, you know, Mario toadstool mushrooms, is adding that white gouache to add those little flakes on the top. They're actually called scales. I just think that makes the piece pop so much. And I don't know if you saw me doing it at any point up close, but you can see that blue pencil on the screen right now, that light blue one off to the right. I love to use that in places that you wouldn't really expect, because it gives a lot of depth and sort of variation in color. It brings your eye to certain areas of the piece. Same with the bright red. So I'll kind of go in with both the bright red and the light blue and add these little tiny pops everywhere, sort of what I'm doing right here. And this final piece, you'll see at the end, but it's not over yet. Did you just hear my dog barking? Basically, I take this, I scan it, and then I'll be adding a black background. And here we splatter paint a little bit of black flecks. You can barely see it, but I think it just adds this really natural, nice texture to the whole piece, and I love to do that at the end or the beginning of some of my pieces. So anyways, while I do this little satisfying bit, yes, I would love to make another video on scanning it, formatting it, adding black in the background. So this piece is not complete, but I would love to film it to completion and show you guys that second half of the process. That all being said and shown, I really hope that you guys enjoyed this. Let me know what you thought in the comments, and I will see you soon.